My name is Gordon Bowden. I spent 12 years in the Royal Air Force as a GenMech GSE engineer. Travelled the world, and then when I left in 1981, Christmas Day in 1981, I was recruited prior to leaving the Air Force as a mining engineer. And I worked for Goldfields of South Africa, one of the biggest, deepest gold mines in the world. 3.5 kilometers below the surface, hard rock mining, with some beautiful people from all over, tribes of all over Africa. And following 5 years there, there was a big mine accident. I was stuck for about 16 hours underground in a cage with 120 screaming tribal people. And I decided to change my life, and I then worked at the University of Transkei in the Eastern Cape for 10 years as a facilities engineer, HVAC and refrigeration. I met some lovely people, Nelson Mandela, Thabo Mbeki, Walter Sisulu, F.W. de Klerk, not so nice, and some very nasty people. I met them. That was because my late wife was specifically in charge of the executive dining room, and I used to provide the security with a 9mm Parabellum Browning. In case there were any people that wanted to create nefarious activity. So I came into this this diatribe of paper back in 2001, where my new partner, who'd lost her husband with cancer, had invested in a capital venture scheme. It was supposed to be a 3-month short-term investment, which turned out with 25% return on that investment, which after 3 months didn't produce the return, and she was persuaded to sign for another 3 months investment, which didn't return. And then she spoke to me and showed me some paperwork, and I noticed that all she had was a cell phone number, mobile phone number. So as an engineer, reasonable at paperwork recovery, I went through the paperwork, noted the individuals involved in the money trail, and started my own investigations just as an engineer. And what I looked at was, one, the telephone number was a satellite phone number, not a normal mobile phone number. And I then conducted, using two attorneys of law, to conduct the paper trail, the money trail, which went to Austria and the City of London. And it was that interested me into how conduit companies move hundreds of billions of pounds through what you call company formations agents, where they set up these companies. And what I'd found in my partner's case was it ended up in one address in the City of London. And that address was 788 790 Finchley Road. If anybody's seen the work that I've put out on the internet, it's focused on one address. And that's what I will try and keep it simple to. From that address, I found out that there were 209,000 shell companies. But not just the amount of companies, because anybody that's in a formations company agency will have to provide due diligence to protect investors or shareholders of those companies that move in and out of that address. Well, I did my own internet search, as you do, right click, and found out that this address was linked to very senior politicians, and I will name them. And if they have any right to stand before me in a court of law, they will have to answer how they were attributed to that address. I include Tony Blair, Windrush Ventures. I include Amber Augusta Rudd, Monticello PLC, and many others. I include David McKenzie Donald Mills, the husband of Tessa Jowell, also linked to that address. I include Silvero Berlusconi and the Mafia, also linked to that address. I include a certain gentleman who is the Derby MP, Chris Williamson, who, when you check his interests through the House of Parliament, you will find out that he was sponsored by a company called UCAT, which is a Labour organisation. He was funded a certain amount of money, and I found out that UCAT as a subsidiary, UCAT Investments. And guess where it came out of? 788 790 Finchley Road. So from following my partner's fraud to the City of London, the conduit was that we took this information to the South African police. And what I did there was the two attorneys of law presented the evidence in the money trail evidence to the Scorpions, who were the National Prosecution Service. But I didn't trust anybody, especially interlocked to the apartheid government, because the people on the fraud document were apartheid senior high commission intelligence officers who defrauded my partner. I then took this information with the two attorneys of law. The Scorpions became involved, who were supposed to be the anti-corruption police. And yet, I found out that the head of the Scorpions, Miss Ayanda Dlodlo, was actually working with the same suspects in the fraud case as a co-director of a worthless mining license in the Democratic Republic of the Congo. So, my trust in my own government fell through the floor, because what I'd found was that members of the apartheid intelligence services were using the City of London to conduit billions, not millions, billions of organized crime money that's linked to senior politicians. I asked anybody, and I will stand before anybody in any court of law, if they can answer some of the questions that I would give them. They would all be in a 6x4. And I speak from the heart as an ex-serviceman, because what I have found out in the last 10, 14 years made me want to be sick of the trust that the military has in politicians who send us to war, as we are finding out recently. One of the people that I found out was linked to Finchley Road, as you know, is Amber Augusta Rudd. And the mere fact that I found out through Michelle that her company, who were involved with Scotska, called FTI Consulting, also came out of 788, 790 Finchley Road. So this is not just assumption, this is fact. And I have called upon every police force that I can come across. I've been there. I've given interviews, even for Michelle, at the murder squad, because we're talking about murder. We're talking about murder to cover up billion-pound organized crime. So when I looked at Finchley Road, I dismantled the whole system, A to Z, every company. It's taken me years. But my knowledge of that is that this is irrefutable evidence. Never mind police cars going to chase somebody who's stolen a chicken from Sainsbury's. This is talking about financial sabotage of our country. And they're moving that money to places like Panama, as you've seen with the Panama Papers. Don't be misled. The Panama Papers, Mossack Fonseca, do not originate out of Panama. They operate out of a London address, out of Hitchin, in Vision House, because Mossack Fonseca UK Limited work with Raymond Morris Group, RM, you know, the tobacco company. And so it's my understanding of how you can take billions of pounds and feed it through hundreds of thousands of shell companies, moving that money, as with Scott's case, was to understand, because that's where I helped Michelle understand, just by looking at the admin companies, is there is the complicity, the actual fraud system that is moving. They are complicit. They are part of a massive organized crime system that just, it doesn't extend just to London. It moves into Vancouver, Canada, Australia. And my expertise in the mining industry also included Michelle's, Scott Gordon Young's companies, Gold Oil PLC, which turned to Barron Oil PLC, is to understand the mechanics as an engineer, to understand the mechanics of how you can use a shell company to move money from a parental company to a subsidiary company, leave £1 in that company, but move hundreds of millions through it, because the tax authorities will look at it in its generated revenue through that parental company to its subsidiary, who they loan money to, the subsidiary, to explore for diamonds, gold, silver. It doesn't matter where in the world, they loan that money The subsidiary company writes it off in exploration fees. There's nothing left. And they've been doing this for generations in my research. Specifically for Michelle, I'll go on to this file, as short as I can. When I looked at Scott Young case, Michelle provided me with certain information on companies where Scott and Michelle, or Scott's shareholdings were. And it was by looking at the administrative company, like Steve and David Jones, I named them, I'm not scared to name them, because these are the people who interacted to prevent Michelle getting justice. Steve and David Jones operated out of certain companies, Esquiline, Developments. And Steve and David Jones, if you check, he's named in the Panama Papers. Did you know?
Yes.
Okay, so I was naming these people in 2007. Not when the Panama Papers were released. I was naming them in 2007. The very same people. So is there any substance to my being able to dismantle these complex systems? Well, I'm an engineer, and that's what I'm reasonably good at. So when I looked at Scott's case, even Grant Thornton, I tried to find out examples, which the internet gives you an ability to just right-click, and the best system that I used was Companies House. And by looking at Companies House or directors, companies in the UK, director check, it gives you an opportunity to cross-reference companies and their directors and their financial history. And that's what this is all about. This is all about understanding, follow the money. That's all it is. But there has to be justice for people like Michelle, who have not spent that time, the thousands, hundreds of thousands of hours, is to look at how you do this in its simplest form. You take one company, one at a time, ask them to explain how they're getting away with it. Well, this report came out. It's called The Folks Corporate Directors Stand In for Fraudsters, Despots, and Spies. And I include spies. You know the recent developments with the two Russian cross-agents. Yeah, well, I said I was also a trained nuclear, chemical, and biological warfare shelter marshal, Deacon Tam, at RAF Lahrbruck in Germany. So I do know a bit about it. That's why when I looked at the recent reports, there were no sparrows or starlings or pigeons lying twitching in the street. But as a trained engineer and serviceman, I would look at false declaration to start conflict somewhere in the world, as we are now seeing. And I'm ashamed. I'm ashamed of my own country, because those politicians that I have named in here, those are the people that will take us to war. So, as I said, the people that I became involved with Michelle, including Grant Thornton, I've got here in an example I will show you later. There are three companies I picked at random. They all emanated out of 790 Finchley Road. So I'm targeting one address. I don't want to make it complicated. If anybody can stand before me, because I've been to the police, I've been to the Jubilee House murder squad, and I didn't just go there for Scott's case. I went there for another gentleman called Richard Chang. Richard Chang was a risk analyst out of Abbey National. Now, we heard the gentleman talk about Santander. Santander took over Abbey National. For how much, we don't know. But I know that for a fact, that Richard Chang ended up being dispatched out of a window, the fifth floor of Abbey National, where he met his demise. There was no blood on the floor, and yet his brain matter was scattered. There was brain matter scattered on the pavement, but no blood. Now, I've done a paramedics course, not just in the Air Force, but in the mining industry. And I know that your heart is still pumping if you're alive, and there would have been blood matter with the matter. So I'm looking at how murder within the banking industry to protect organized crime. And I'm sure Richard Chang would have found out exactly what I've been finding out, is that senior executives of the banks are moving money to companies that they are also directors of in order to asset strip the banks. And that's, in short, how when you talk about money laundering within admin systems, accountants and auditors, there has to be overview by either a judicial process or a police inquiry into understanding how company formations agents have never been examined. Well, that's what I've been quite a good, not an expert, I just got a lot of time being a retired person, but understanding the mechanics of how you can move money. So I've offered it. Anybody wants to speak to me from the police, I've offered the police, and they've all run away. Because if you'd start to talk about corruption within the City of London, you're talking about the blood and guts of the City of London. I don't think they care where the money comes from or who it destroys bringing the money in. And that's my pain of knowing what I know. I will try my very best to try to bring these people to justice. Whether it's Tony Blair, Amber Rudd, David Cameron, I don't care who they are. They're only people like us. They have what we call due diligence and a duty of care. That if they're involved in any nefarious activity, they should stand trial just the same as anybody else that we... because I never forget, they're public servants. That's what they are, first and foremost. And say...
Amber Rudd is the person, is this correct? She's the Home Secretary of this country.
Correct.
And she is running the 40 murder inquiry, which correct. Includes Scott Young.
Correct.
And she's interlinked with companies.
Yes.
With an accountancy firm that could be implicated in
it
the
is.
Fraud.
It is, because I know. I do get great joy out of watching people run. You know, when I've named them, whether it be on an internet blog, they've tried to take me to court. I said, let's do it. And the reason I said let's do it, because I have correspondence and people who have taken on board what I've said. Now, say this company in Namibia bought a worthless plot of dirt for $100,000. They sold it 6 months later for $2.5 billion. So I was contacted by French anti-money laundering experts who I've spent 5 years communicating with. They've sent me... gratitude for helping them understand. And that resulted in Europe's fourth most powerful woman, Miss Anne Laveron, being dismissed from Areva Nuclear France. Not only that, you will find out, and anybody can check, Jean Duplessis from Rio Tinto has just resigned from Rio Tinto. But the other directors included Miss Anne Laveron. And Miss Anne Laveron left a company called Vodafone because she was involved with another gentleman called Sir Samuel Essendjona, a Ghanaian gentleman, multi-millionaire, who was also involved with Uramin Inc., which sold the worthless plot of dirt to Areva Nuclear. And that's how you call, talking about coincidence, I don't believe in, I'm an engineer.
I think this is marvelous, and I do want to talk to you more.
Okay.
Michelle Young, you had a question that you wanted to pose, or please use the microphone.
Yes, what I would like to ask you, Gordon, regarding Scott's ex-girlfriend, who was the last person to see Scott alive, who left the apartment 15 minutes before he was found dead.
Yeah.
Is this correct? Stephen David Jones, the lawyer who restructured the assets through these shell companies, then set up companies with Scott Young's ex-girlfriend.
He did.
Months after his death.
He did, and I mentioned that. It's all recorded. I spent 1¾ hours with the Jubilee House police squad, murder and serious organised crime. In that recorded interview, I gave testimony to them saying that how can the police ignore that the only testimony witness, which is an open verdict on Scott Gordon Young of non-suicide, because it was an open verdict, that Elizabeth Noel Reno, if you know how I deconstruct, operated out of using two ID numbers. And it's the mere fact that I know how to do this, is that I looked at the companies and when they were formed, and the companies were formed 2 weeks, I believe 2 weeks after Scott's death. So how can her testimony of what was said in a phone call be accurate if she then signs as a company director with the very person who was in charge of Scott's funds? And then I found out that Elizabeth Noel Reno's father, I believe, was also a director of Schlumberger. Schlumberger give the resources on oil wells throughout the world. And Ronald Reno gave the Schlumberger report for, please don't buy any shares in the Gatwick Gusher, because it was run by David Anthony Lenigas and his cronies, who have 147 companies, never found anything.
We are the power behind the ITNJ. Add your voice. Sign the treaty.